Hello everybody, this is a video of me ranting about my experience with Windows for the last couple of years. I don't want to forget anything, and if I leave myself free to express myself, it will probably be one big F from beginning to end. So what I have done is, I have written down some things I want to say. I'm basically going to read them, more or less. Alright, let's do this. This is not directed just to Microsoft. This is mainly to Microsoft and Nvidia. But if I wanted to say more, I could say more about other companies too, in the whole Windows ecosystem. Alright, now, Microsoft. They do all they can to push Windows 10. They make using previous versions more and more annoying just to push Windows 10. They have now officially switched on the bundling of patches on Windows 8.1, probably 7. Not sure about, well, XP is dead for them, so it doesn't really matter. They are bundling the patches updates of Windows into single file, single installations. So one installation does several things, and you cannot pick which one. This is from Microsoft to the user base of Windows 8.1 and probably 7. Now, if this hasn't happened to you yet, don't worry, it will. Now, their goal is to frustrate the users enough to consider the users jumping ship to Windows 10, because, you know, if everything is as bad as Windows 10, as in Windows 10, we might as well jump to Windows 10, because it's newer and, you know, whatever. Microsoft. Now, Windows 10 is not just as bad as Windows 8.1 and Windows 7, and Microsoft is not really trying to hide it, although they're definitely not announcing it. As you might know, well, I hope you do know, keystrokes are recorded and sent to Microsoft. All of them. Files opened, files checked, documents, images, whatever, everything you do, as long as, of course, your system is online, is sent to Microsoft servers. Now, I'm not talking about the actual files. No, obviously not. But information about these files. Microsoft just refuses to comment on it. Nvidia. Oh, Nvidia. Now, I was never a huge fan of them. They're definitely trying to make me hate them. Personally. I hadn't installed new drivers since late August 2016. Tonight is the 18th of October here now. And it will be past midnight by the time I upload this. Now, what's the problem? Well, I noticed earlier that I couldn't access my GeForce Experience application. It just wasn't there anymore, and I found myself wondering if something went wrong. So what I did was, well, let's manually check for new drivers. I went to the Nvidia site, and of course, as I knew there was going to be a new driver, there were new drivers. I downloaded the drivers. Of course, it is bundled with the latest GeForce Experience. I went on to install, and I installed everything because, you know, why not? When I finished installing, it automatically, well, because it had a tick, ran GeForce Experience, and from what I remember, it was the same, more or less, application as before. Cool, I thought. I restarted the computer because that's what I do when I install new drivers to make sure that everything goes smoothly. And I said to myself, alright, let's run GeForce Experience because I want to try Shadowblade again. I right-click on the desktop. No GeForce Experience shortcut. Well, that's weird. I checked the icon in the system tray and okay, the option to go to GeForce Experience was there. Alright, I guess they decided to remove it. It's strange though, isn't it? I mean, I was thinking at the time, why did my GeForce Experience just disappear in the first place? I mean, before I updated now the drivers. Anyway, let's see what happens. And GeForce Experience opens. I think it said it had a document to read and agree with. Obviously, I didn't think about it that much. I clicked I agree, and GeForce Experience, the program, opened. Or did it? No, because while I got the window of the application, I got no access. First of all, the application changed how it looks, and more importantly, I cannot access anything. No options, no check drivers, no Shadowplay, nothing. Why? Because in the middle of the screen of the application window, I now have an option. One option. Get started. Okay, that's weird. I mean, I already run the application. I know I want to run the application. I click on get started and it demands that I log in with my NVIDIA login or my Facebook login or my Google login. Why do I have to log in with anything anywhere to check my drivers? Why do I have to log in to use an application which already exists and has nothing to do with going online? And it's not like you have the option to not log in. No. You have to log in or else you cannot use GeForce Experience. This is another bullying tactic, similar to Microsoft, taking away from the user and placing what the user wants behind a wall, a gate, that an online gate that they choose to place there so that they can control and basically spy on you. Why the fudge do I have to log in anywhere to check my fudging graphics driver, my Shadowplay, my anything that had to do with GeForce Experience? There's no good reason for that for the user. None. The amount of sickening behavior by Microsoft, Nvidia, and others keeps piling up. I'm at a point where I don't want to use any of this shit anymore. Obviously, I have to use something. I want to throw up. I want to get the CEO of Microsoft and of Nvidia, for starters, and throw up inside their fucking mouths, just, and then make them kiss. Mother. I'm considering, and no, I don't think I'm going to jump to Linux, because Linux has a myriad other problems, other issues. One of it are the actual Linux users, who are like little fascists who tell you what you have to do to do it right. That only what they believe is the right thing to do is the right thing to do. Of course, there are exceptions, but man, they are annoying. If I had the money, and of course, if Apple actually released a new computer eventually, I will buy an, I can't believe I'm saying this, I will buy an Apple computer to use as a daily computer. Imagine that, if Apple has become the point of reference. Oh my. This must be the Twilight Zone. I miss TOS and Workbench. I miss them.
Get ready. Race for the top position. Get ready. Race for the top position. Get ready. Race for the top position.
Yeah. Get ready.